the channel, or welcome if you are new. I'm Kitty, and today we're doing another episode of Building Newcrest. I think this is episode 4 or part 4, if I'm not mistaken. So far, I have built a starter house, an affordable family house that was 40,000 simoleons, and a library. And today, we're going back to the first neighborhood that I started in, and we're building a bigger house. I don't know if I would call this a family house, but it could be. It could be renovated into one. It has 2 bedrooms, but I made both the bedrooms very neutral so that they just have like, they could both be master bedrooms basically. They look like they're designed for adults, but you could easily renovate this if you had kids or something. And I really, really like this house. I think it turned out really cool. Very like luxurious. It has really nice things in it. It's not huge. Again, this lot isn't that big. I think this is a 30 by 20 lot, which isn't big, but again, I'm not very good at building big, so to me this house is sort of big, but it's not really. So we are going for the same style again today as for the previous houses in this neighborhood that you can sort of see in the background. My building Newcrest is very modern. That is the theme that I decided on. And on those houses back there, we went for these windows that have like the horizontal lines going across them. So I definitely wanted to use the same windows, at least in some parts of this house, to kind of bring in the same theme. And then we are going for this kind of a monochrome vibe. I went for blue in one of the houses before and for green in the other one. But this one from the outside is basically kind of gray. And we are going with the green roofs again, like I have done for the other houses. But from the inside, we do have some color. We have some yellows in this house, some blues, and some greens, I would say. It's all black and white, don't you worry. I know that can get pretty boring, but from the outside, I did want it to like match the neighborhood and the theme here. It's kind of like this very modern, kind of like boxy black and white theme. But I didn't want to make a box house. I made so many of these little extensions of the house so it would look more interesting. And I do really like how it turned out in the end. I was struggling a bit to begin with. I didn't kind of know what I wanted to put where. On the left side of the house, we have these 2 huge pillars. They're supposed to be like stone pillars to just make it look more interesting. I don't use the room inside those like pillar rooms. They aren't supposed to be like living space. They are just supposed to be like outer pillars. So they are in like living space. And then on the right side, we have this like balcony, and this is a dining room downstairs and in the back of the house. I'm gonna extend it a little bit more. We're gonna have another balcony, quite a big balcony upstairs, and then downstairs we're having like a huge patio area, which is really cool. It goes like over the pool, so there is a pool here. I haven't put a pool before in this neighborhood because pools are really expensive, and both the houses that I built were on a budget, but this one, I don't even know how much this cost in the end. I did not pay any attention, and I just realized I forgot to do the lot trades, but I think I would definitely go for fast internet. Maybe we could go for something like natural light, so if you wanted to be a photographer or something. And then, oh my god, I forgot to do them. That is so annoying. The last one, maybe we would go for bracing breezes. Is that even what it's called? You know, the fitness one? Maybe that one. I don't know. I'll put them before I put this on the gallery. They will be on this. If I remember, I might forget, but hopefully I remember because I like to do them because this is my neighborhood. I want all the houses to have lot trades. I just forgot about them because like, they are not there. You have to open that little like info button to get to see them. So I just seem to always forget about them. But this lot is called the Fern. Is it the Fern? I can't see. Something Park. So was this supposed to be a park? I don't know. Or is that just what they name the lot? I don't know. But I made this like just a residential lot. I don't know. But I thought it was a good residential lot. The lot next to this one, the bigger one, which is between all these houses, that one is going to be a community lot. I still haven't decided which one or what I'm going to put there. But I'm going to read your guys' suggestions and then do that. At some point, I don't know what we're gonna do next. Probably a community lot, but I don't know which one. And this backyard, we're doing it now. I love it. I love that little area, like the little kind of like dock that goes over the pool. The pool is pretty big. And then I put a little fire pit thingy in the middle there that is like lowered down on another level. And I thought that was so cool. I really like that a lot. And then we're actually gonna make a little like different house for this jacuzzi as well, a little gazebo kind of thing. So it's also elevated on this foundation like the rest of the house, and it has a roof, and it's pretty cool. It's very simple. It's a square, as you can see, but I thought that was cute. There was extra space on the lot and I didn't want to leave it all empty since we had all the money in the world, so I just made a little jacuzzi house thingy here. Why not? Again, that is kind of luxurious to have your own jacuzzi. I did block off, like, I didn't block off, but I put some, like, bushes on the left side there, so the lot next to this one wouldn't be able to see straight into the jacuzzi, so you kind of have your own privacy. But these aren't gated, well, how do you say it? These aren't gated houses, gated lots. I don't usually put gates, like, or fences, sorry. They're not fenced. I never use fences around the house. Sometimes I make the backyard fenced, but I just don't think it's very common here where I live in Finland to have, like, a gated lot. So I never even think about doing that, but maybe I could have done that to make it a little bit more, like, private so you have your own privacy, but I don't know, we don't have it, so, oh well, it's just not my style again. I guess it's because I never see it, so I never think that, oh, maybe I should do that. But we have moved on to the indoors now, and oh my god, this floor plan gave me a lot of trouble. I cut out of me doing this, most of it. You're gonna see in a second, so we're gonna cut out, and it's gonna be perfect then, but I just didn't know where to put the stairs. That was my issue. Always, I just put the stairs in fast before I even finish the exterior. But I don't because I'm silly. So then I end up with a huge issue like, oh crap, where can I put the stairs? They don't fit anywhere. But I did find a spot for them. The only issue with it is that the entry area in the house is quite big. It's like a big room. It's bigger than the little sitting, like, seating area, seating lounge. So, like, I had a huge problem. Like, what am I gonna put in this room? That's like the entry room. This doesn't look like anything should be here, but it turns out fine in the end. Downstairs, we're gonna have the kitchen and dining room, a little lounge here on the corner with the windows, this entryway, and then another little lounge with, like, bookshelves and a computer, a bathroom, and then another entryway where you go outside. And then upstairs, we're gonna have two bedrooms. None of them have en-suites on this house because it's not that big. We have one bathroom upstairs though, and then we have that, like, living room area upstairs, and then we have the two balconies. So, I mean, there is a lot of room here, but maybe I could have done the floor plan a little bit better. Again, I suck at floor planning. This is something you know if you watch my channel. I'm trying to get better at it, but maybe I should just, like, create the rooms first and then do the outside of the house. Oh my god, the house would end up looking so weird. I don't even know, but this is the kitchen. This might be one of my favorite rooms. I always tend to really like the kitchens in all my houses. I don't know, kitchens are just so cozy and they always just tend to look really, really good. I put some of these items in here, like, in the middle of doing the floor planning because I just wanted to see where everything was going to go. So I was going to be sure that there was enough space for a kitchen. And I love this, like, layout of this kitchen. I love the little kitchen aisle in the middle that is a square with two little bar stools on it as well. I thought that was so cute and I love these wallpapers. And then we're using the counters again that I use everywhere because they're just the only, almost the only, like, well, there's only, like, one other full white counter that isn't, like, traditional looking. I want modern, so I was using those ones again, but oh well, they look really cute. And this new table from Fitness Stuff, I think this one, I think it's from Fitness Stuff, and these chairs are new too, might be from Fitness Stuff as well, but I completely forgot where they are from. But also obsessed with these copper wire lamps from the same stuff pack, Fitness Stuff. I'm using those in all these houses, and in this house you have them inside, you have them outside, you have them on the balconies, you have them everywhere basically because they are just so cool. I love, like, how modern and how different colors they come in, and there's, like, all the different metallics. You can have it black, you can have it silver, gold, or copper, and I just think it's very, very cool. We're using, like, these other different hanging lamps on top of the kitchen arc, so I want to have something there that, I don't know, just added a little bit of something, and I really like those as well. But yeah, oh my god, it's a 20-minute video. I usually don't talk for this long because my speed builds, I don't like to make them that long. I never want to do speed builds that are two parts because I feel like my viewers won't be that interested. Maybe if I had, like, a million people subscribed, I could do two-part builds, but right now I don't want to. That's why I don't build huge buildings, because I do not want to do, like, a 35-minute voiceover for a 35-minute video. Who's gonna watch that? Maybe some of you, but, like, come on, that's a bit too long. So I try to, like, make these a little bit shorter. I cut out some of the boring parts, and this is sped up by 7 times. Is it going too fast for you guys? What do you think? Because it is quite fast, but hopefully it's not too crazy. I know I turn the camera sometimes quite a lot when I'm just like looking around, like seeing what I should do next. But tell me down in the comments if you think it's going too fast and I can slow it down. That means the video is going to be longer, and like, what the heck am I going to talk about for 25 minutes? Also, yesterday, randomly, I never have back pain. If I do, I have like lower back pain. I don't even know why. But yesterday when I woke up with like serious like upper back pain. Like every move that I make hurts so much and it sucked. I was gonna post this build yesterday, but I did not feel like doing a 20-minute voiceover because I was just not feeling good. I was really tired as well. I think I must have slept really weird. Like, I don't know what I've done. Like, how could I make my whole back ache like that? I don't know, that's never happened before. So I was hoping that when I slept through this night from yesterday to today, it would just go away and everything would be great, but no, it's still here today. Horrible back pain. Don't know where it came from, what it's doing. I hope it's gonna go away soon because this is not supposed to be happening and it sucks. But if I don't move, it's okay. It's just every little movement hurts a lot. But right now I'm just sitting talking, so that should be okay. And oh my god, yesterday I went out and we are gonna get a new internet. We went to like I was gonna call it the internet store, I don't know, the internet provider, their little store office space, I don't know. We went there because we currently have Wi-Fi and our internet is really good. Like, Finland is great with internet, at least around like the more like urban areas. Yeah, we have amazing internet. It's really, really fast. Like, even the Wi-Fi on my laptop, my videos upload, like if it's a 5-minute video, it's gonna upload in less than 5 minutes. If it's a 20-minute video, it might upload in like 10-15 minutes. So we have really great like upload speed and so on. So I have no like problems with that. But we are gonna get wired internet, so Ethernet now, because I feel like that will just, I don't know, because it doesn't cost that much more and it's gonna be better. I don't know that much about the technicalities, I'm not like a computer genius, but it's gonna be wired, which means I can hopefully start streaming, because I've been wanting to do that for a while now. I did one stream on YouTube a few months back. It was some kind of a subscriber milestone special stream and it did not go well. It was really fun, but the stream kept cutting out every 10 minutes and I would have to restart it and it would work again just fine. So no idea why it would do that. Why would it work perfectly for 10 minutes and then just cut out? Don't know, but I'm assuming it might have something to do with the fact that I was on Wi-Fi instead of wired connection. So we are gonna get a wired connection for my computer now, my new computer, so I could start streaming, which I'm really excited about. I want to hear if you guys want to see my streams on YouTube or on Twitch. I know Twitch has a lot better like moderating system, and I mean Twitch is a really cool platform, so I probably want to start streaming on Twitch, but I know most of you guys would see my streams better if they were on YouTube, so we'll see. This will still be a while because I need to set everything up. I need to make sure my computer has everything it needs for streaming, but I think that could be so much fun and I have so much time. Like, I work from home, so I could be streaming all the time. I don't know, I want to make a schedule and everything, but hopefully that is happening soon. Our new internet is going to be installed on Monday, hopefully. It's Thursday now, so in a few days, next week, we should have better internet. It probably won't even seem that different, honestly, but it should at least help with the streaming. So I'm really excited about that. I also went shopping yesterday when we went to the internet provider. After that, I went shopping because, oh my god, I want to decorate for fall and Christmas. But I was tweeting about this just the other day. My Twitter is simmerkittenyt, by the way. If you're not following, go do that. I really want to decorate, but Finland does not have good, like homeware or cute homeware or like decorations. We don't have any cute stores. We used to have this like big, kind of like a department store that had always had like seasonal stuff. I would always go there for Christmas and Easter to get all these cute decorations, but they got bankrupt. Yeah, they filed for bankruptcy. They're down now. Oh, they're not anymore. And it sucks. They just, I don't know what happened to them, but they are no more. So there is nowhere to get any cute homeware, and it's really bothering me because I really want to decorate, and I could always order online, but then you have to pay for the shipping, and that costs so much. So I don't know. This is just my issue, because I can decorate in The Sims so much, but then I can't decorate my actual apartment, and it's bumming me out. But I did find a few little cute decor pieces. I bought a new wreath for the door. Is that what they're called? I think so. Like a kind of like a autumnal slash Christmassy wreath. And then I got some fairy lights that I'm gonna be putting up in my room here where I record. I think those will be really cute. And some balls for Christmas. Some Christmas balls already. My boyfriend was laughing at me that it's like October 3rd. Was it 3rd yesterday? 4th. I'm already buying Christmas stuff. But like, come on, Christmas is everything. I love Christmas. I love fall, but I cannot wait for Christmas. Like, Christmas is amazing. I love Christmas so much. And I'm not a big Halloween fan because, first of all, we don't celebrate Halloween here in Finland. We never have. It's never been like one of those things that you celebrate. We don't go trick-or-treating or anything. It's kind of coming in now from like, you know, US has a big influence on all the other countries as well. So we do have some little decorations here, but I don't like scary stuff, so I don't really like Halloween that much. I do love pumpkins. Pumpkins are adorable. I love how bright and orange they are. I wish I had some pumpkins just as decorations around my apartment, but I don't like Halloween, so I'm really excited for Christmas, and Christmas is coming soon. It's 2 months, 2.5 months until Christmas, so I'm excited about that. Tell me down in the comments if you are excited too. But I do want to do some kind of Halloween build this year that will come out obviously at the end of the month. What would you guys like to see? Like a haunted house or something? I don't know. I won't do more than one because just it's not my style, and I won't be very good at building something like that. But this weekend on Saturday, I do want to do like an autumnal build again. I did an autumnal bedroom already, but I maybe want to do like a community lot, a park, like a what, like one of those places where you go and pick out your pumpkins. I don't know. If you guys have ideas what you would like to see as like an autumnal build, let me know, and I'll be reading your guys' comments like I always do. But yeah, I don't even know what I've been rambling on this whole time. We've just been furnishing the entire house. Oh yeah, there's a little office up here as well. I forgot to mention that there's an office. It just has two computers. It's very small again. Does it have two computers? No. It has two desks, but only one of them has a computer. And then the two bedrooms. And then this is a living room area here with a fireplace and a TV. And again, we have a bit of an awkward space up here where I put the fish tank, because that's where you go outside and there's a lot of windows. So I wasn't really sure what to do with that space, but it's okay. I like both of these bedrooms. They are quite different, but they could both be the Batmaster bedroom. And again, if you want to live in this house, you can refurnish them and make one of them for kids or something. You can definitely fit like two or even three like kids beds in there if you have a bigger family. And after I stopped recording, I've noticed I forgot to furnish the upstairs bathroom. So that isn't gonna be furnished on camera because I just completely forgot about it, but it took me about 60 seconds to furnish. It's just tiny, it's like 2x3, so I just put in like a shower, a TV, and a sink and a mirror. There's probably a picture of it in the screenshots in the end, but yeah, hope you guys do like this house. What else did I want to talk about today? I feel like that was pretty much it. I don't know, like, it's a 21 minute video. I need to like come up with something to talk about, or I'm just gonna talk about the build the whole time and you guys are gonna get so bored. But yeah, leave me suggestions down in the comments what kind of autumnal builds I could still do. Autumnal create a Sims. I already did a lookbook, like a full lookbook, which was so much fun to do. If you haven't seen that, definitely go check that out, because I did put a lot of work into that. And then if you haven't seen my machinima that I just did, which was like a vlog or like a day in the life of a YouTuber, that's so much fun to do as well. Like, I actually really enjoyed doing that, and it took a lot of work as well, so go check that out. My collab came out last weekend, which was amazing. So much fun to do a collab with so many different amazing simmers. That was a baby apartment. I've had some great videos come out lately, if I say so myself. So if you have missed those, go check them out and subscribe if you haven't already. And you can even turn on my notifications with the little bell button next to the subscribe button if you want to get notified. What's the word? If you want to get notified when I upload new videos. Anyways, let's share another piece of fan art in today's video. Today I have this one, which comes from Lucy, and she said she loves my videos, thank you very much. And she made my fan art a chibi because my aesthetic is very kawaii. So This is adorable. Like, what is this? This is so cute. Thank you so much for sending me that. That is just adorable. I don't know. It's just too cute. So thank you so much. My fan art email is down in the description if you want to send me fan art. But yeah, that is it. Here are the screenshots. There is a lot of them. But if you want to download this house, I'm going to put it on the gallery. You can find it under my username, which is SimmerKittenYT, or under the hashtag SimmerKitten, which is where you can find all my creations. There is no CC in this house, like there is never in any of my builds. Oh, and on the gallery post, I'm going to write where you need to place this house. It was the Fern Park or something. That lot, if you want to have my complete Newcrest world, once it is done, it's gonna take a while because we've done 4 now and there's like 15 lots or something, so it's gonna take a while, but eventually, hopefully, I will be able to finish this and you guys will be able to download this. Also, I'm looking to start a new little small challenge for like a month before Cats and Dogs comes out, so if you guys have suggestions for that, let me know. Give the video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it and subscribe if you haven't already, and any other build suggestions for Newcrest are also welcome. Just, you can always suggest me things. I always read my comments. Sorry I can't reply to all of them, but I do read them. So thank you so much for all the love and all the comments. And yeah, hope you are having a wonderful day. Thank you so much for watching this video and listening to me ramble for 21 minutes. And I will see you guys again tomorrow. Bye-bye!